Hi, we welcome you on today's whiteboard session. Today's whiteboard session is about skill, will, matrix. This is one matrix that can bring about a complete transformation in your organization. Complete change, if you're looking for, will come by this one single simple matrix that you have to actually understand. Today I'm going to talk about four kinds of people in your organization. How either they are taking your organization or they're pulling it back. What to do? If you're a $1 million company, you can become a $1 billion company just by practicing one skill will matrix. Let's see what to do. There are some people in the organization who got high will but low skill. These are those people who got high will. They're actually new recruitments. New people who join in your organization. They've just joined. इनको पता नहीं है क्या करना है, क्यों करना है, कब करना है, कहां करना है, कैसे करना है. They don't know why to do, what to do, where to do, when to do, how to do, but they want to do. इनकी इच्छा शक्ति बहुत ज्यादा है. They've got high will but low skill. These are mostly those people who come new in the organization. They're called monkey called managers. You know, a monkey has got high energy but doesn't know what to do, where to go. This monkey who's always jumping. Monkey, why? Because one monkey can do sex 8 to 12 times in a day. He's got very high energy. I'm not saying they're coming to do sex in the organization, but what they are coming with, very high energy but doesn't know what to do. How do you... They have no idea what to... Jab bhi organization join karte hain, while they are joining, they have a very revolutionary desire to do something great in the organization. Ye kuch karke dikhana chahte. They want to build a great career. They kuch organization ke liye kuch karna chahte hain. But they don't know how to do it. Then there are people who got very high skill. These are mostly departmental heads, very senior people, purane ho chuke hain, manjhe hue hain, jam chuke hain, jante hain kya karna hai, kyun karna hai, kab karna hai, kahan karna hai, kaise karna hai. 80% of the organization business is actually taken care by these people. Sometimes, due to having a long vintage in the organization, sometimes their will is little lower side. But their skill is very high, certainly. Then there are some people, na to will hai, na skill hai. These are parasites, very easy. Parasites are those people, hum to dubenge sanam, tumko bhi le dubenge. These are those people who are actually, ye jab bhi organization join karte hain, they're not looking for karna kya hai. They're looking for ya chalti kiski hai company mein. And they'll go and take shelter of all those people jinki organization mein chalti hai. Then there are people who got high will and high skill. These are visionaries. Visionaries are actually smart people in the organization. They know everything. They've got very high will, high skill. Top people mostly, CXO level and other senior people. Very good values and lot of performance. So they have been promoted to a position of visionary. So in organization, if the visionary wants to see my organization is, let's say, a $1 million company and I want to take it to a $1 billion company, what to do? What to do bring that kind of a change? What to do? What are the changes required in the organization? So he is looking at them. But you know what? I have a question to all of you. My question to all of you is, who do you think is most dangerous amongst four? So this is quadrant 1, 2, 3 and 4. Who do you think is most dangerous amongst all of four? A lot of people think monkeys, they can do a lot of damage in the organization because they're new, they don't know what to do. A lot of people think parasites are dangerous. Some people may think they are dangerous. Otherwise, they are good performers. They have been great, consistent performers. But I'll tell you, to your surprise, Jack Welch says, the most dangerous people are these people who are actually star performers. They're most dangerous. But you know why they're most dangerous? They are most dangerous क्योंकि कई बार क्या होता है, when they get old in the vintage, उन्हें पता है क्या करना है, क्यों करना है, कैसे करना है, कहां करना है, कब करना है, पर करना नहीं है. They know why to do, what to do, when to do, how to do, where to do, but they don't want to do. This willingness is actually missing in them. So what's happening is, sometimes these parasites, they know इनका बड़ा पुराना vintage है, they go and take shelter of these people. And you know what happens, eventually इनके बीच में nexus बन जाता है. And they develop a very strong nexus in the organization. Because parasite jata hai, paon chhuta hai, jaake star performer ke, he takes shelter of the star performer, and the star performer ko bhi, because of the ego is high, toh wo bhi isko shabashi deta hai. And you know what happens? Eventually they create a nexus. Now these new people, they want to do something new, so they go to the departmental heads. Sir, I want to learn something new. Can I learn from you? And you know what happens? Department heads will tell them, beta, jitna sikhaya, utna karo. Do what you are supposed to. Don't come back to me. Jitna bataya utna karo. Because of some insecurities, they don't encourage the leadership development. And when the leadership is not getting developed, they don't encourage leadership development. What's happening? The organization is stagnant. Inki ichha khatam ho jati hai kuch karne ki. They came with a desire to actually do something great in the organization. So monkeys, who are actually new people, they are normally GETs and DETs, they are engineer trainees. They join the organization with a vision to do something. They come and take the learnings and lessons. But star performers, inke enthusiasm ko poison laga rahe the. They put poison to their enthusiasm. When they go back, inka willingness kam ho jata hai, initiative kam ho jata hai, confidence kam ho jata hai, morale kam ho jata hai. They think, yaar, Raghupati Raghav Rajaram, jitni tankha utna kaam. So they are actually not taking an initiative and not working hard to transform the organization. So what's happening? What's happening? The visionary is always thinking, he's in a question mark. He thinks, kaise company ko aage badhaye, what to do? Because the visionary is thinking, what to do? These are actually not performing. There is a nexus here, a very strong nexus here. Ye kuch karna chahte the, inhone karna band kar diya. They are not taking any initiative. Ab sabka sab inke haath mein hai, but they are stagnant. They are stagnant. They are doing what they are doing. And if you continue doing what you're doing, you will continue getting what you're getting. Ab wahi karte rahe jo karte aa rahe the, aapko wahi milta rahega jo milta aa raha tha. Now, Jack Welch explains here what should visionary do to change the organization. The best thing that a visionary can do is start working on these top performers. He will have to do two things. One, evaporate or purify. First is evaporate, second is purify. Evaporate or purify. Evaporate or purify. He will have to start doing a counseling and coaching with these people and may have to take some of them out of the organization. By doing this, what will happen is there'll be a very clear indication and this nexus will get broken up. Second thing what he has to do is he has to train up these monkeys. They've got very high will, but they don't have skill. They've got very high will, but they don't have skill. And if you train them up, they will start moving into this direction. Take the monkeys here. Monkeys will become visionaries also. Why? Because the skill was missing. You know, when the will is there, getting skill is not difficult. But if the skill is there, will is not there, you're poisonous and dangerous. You can actually poison the entire organization. Enthusiasm, culture, credibility. In fact, the culture of responsibility, ownership, initiative will also go down because these people don't take enough initiatives. Now what happens? He starts training them. So the culture of training comes in here. A lot of skill building and trainings will start here and they will move eventually to this direction. And then what happens? Ye badhne lag jata hai. The entire size actually starts growing. And when this size starts to grow, what happens? This nexus will get evaporated. So there are some people who kehte hain, when you do trainings with them, they kehte hain, Bindra ji, aapka kehna to sahi hai, par maine rehna wahi hai. So they are not ready to change. So what he did was, he started deleting some of these people to take them out of the organization. What happened? There was a very clear indication given to these people. So some of them, they also started moving out or they started going upwards. So this is called purification or evaporation. The entire contamination changes from purification or evaporation. And you know what happened? This size started to increase in the organization. I'll give it a new color. This size of the organization started to increase. So, this was the shade of all non-performers which actually went out of the organization. There was a very clear communication about the cultural change in the organization. The communication was, if you got very high will, we will recognize you. And effort that is recognized gets repeated. 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 And this is what's happening. Now, when they were actually recognized, when the will is recognized, the skill can be developed. And this is what is called skill-will matrix. If in your organization, start recognizing people who take extra ownership, initiative, responsibility, I'm telling you, the message will spread across. The message will spread across and the right value system will start developing in the organization. With these values, you can transform the entire organization. Don't have these heavy people who knows what to do, why to do, where to do, when to do, how to do, but they don't want to do. Have those people who have a very serious want to do. That's what. In fact, the Vedic scriptures are also saying, Tatra lolyam api ekalam mulyam janma koti sukritirna labhyate. Lolyam. The intense desire to perform something is the one qualification. Ekalam mulyam, ekalam mulyam, ekalam mulyam, lolyam api ekalam mulyam. Intense desire to perform something is the qualification for a man to actually grow and bounce back in tough times. These are those people who had high will. If you stop recognizing them, they will die. They will either leave your organization. They might leave your organization. Even if you give them highest salaries, money is no motivation for a man to stay back. Let me tell you something. People who are giving highest salaries are also having some employee turnover ratio. If you think salary is a motivation, then the organizations which are giving very high salaries will have zero employee turnover. But people are leaving even those organizations. So what is important is will. So like I explained to you, people who have high will, the golden statement is your determination determines your destination. Your determination determines your destination. Your determination determines your destination. What happens? Visionaries, they decided training them up. And they had high determination. They had high will. And this became their destination. When you start recognizing the will, then you can easily give them skill. But there are people who have high skills, but they don't have any will. They're poisonous, liability, dangerous people in the organization who will take away the enthusiasm, ownership, initiative, responsibility. Understand the skill-will matrix. Start recognizing people who are actually with the high will and taking ownership, initiative, responsibility. Give them promotion, take them up, train them up. This is skill-will matrix. Keep watching more videos. Thank you very much.